He's killing whatever he got.
Okay, well, that was our little gator here in the back pond. We figured we'd start the video with this. All right.
A little bit off cue.
The gator was not in the.
Okay, so
in the script.
Here is part 11B, and girls, hey, son, we got to do part 11B. Okay, so we showed you the interior view. This is part 11B of the exterior of the things that we covered on the inside to an extent. We're going to start off with, like I said, we are actually using the camper this weekend. We're actually camping, so we're going to show you our setup and a couple things I like that we've done. One of the things we're going to start off with is, prior to the cargo trailer conversion, we used to tent camp. So with tent camping, the tent was sleeping. This was our kitchen. This is from Bass Pro Shops, their camp kitchen. This is what we used, which worked out really nice. You got storage bags here that zip, that actually have some nice shelving. There's shelving, they have adjustable straps. You can keep, obviously, bread, whatever. And it keeps the raccoons out, whatever. It's a laminated particle board type stuff that is kind of metal. So what I used to do was, on this side, I used to put the stove over here. It has a sink. It's got hooks for all your utensils. This is actually spice racks. Like I said, it's got the sink, storage underneath. This side is specifically for your grill. As you can see, it's all mesh. This is actually a paper towel holder. You know, you have your roll of paper towel, slide it through, and then you can hang it. This is I believe it was 20,000 BTU, Robbie?
Yeah, I believe it was.
20,000 BTU gas grill.
Stainless
that
steel.
We got from Cabela's, or it's a Cabela's grill, which we got on eBay for $110,
yeah.
But it is all stainless steel. The exterior, the cooking grates, everything. Definitely well worth the money because it's stainless steel. A lot of your gas grills, you buy a cheaper one. The burners are metal. This is just, for us, this was a good deal. It was a little bit more money, but we definitely got really good quality, and once again, an eBay score for us. Runs off a 1 pound propane bottle. So.
I'll show you that. Not like anybody doesn't know what a bottle looks like, but.
So that covers that.
Well, while you're at the small propane bottle, how about refilling?
Sure, let's do that. One of the other things that we have found on YouTube is basically this bottle of propane cost us $4. It was a 2-pack at Walmart. I think it was like 2 for $8. So, you know, of course, I'm a big YouTuber. There's so many people I have watched. I give kudos to everybody, and there's a lot of it out there. Is you can refill these 1 pound bottles yourself. So what I found was, I'll let Robbie kind of zoom in, that will show you this fitting. All right. So basically what you do with this is this screws into your 20 pound propane tank. You screw on that bottle to this end. And you can refill your own propane bottles. I'm not going to go into a whole lot of depth. You have to YouTube that because I could do a whole video on just refilling. But you refilling 1 pound propane bottles that you paid good money for is very cost effective. Here in Florida, you can refill a 20 pound propane tank for $15. That amount of propane, if you bought these bottles, would cost you like $130. You can save yourself, I want to say it's like 700%. The savings is phenomenal, and it's very simple. You connect them, you have to get the propane bottles cold. There's videos out there that let you do that. This is worth it. This was $7 on eBay. There, you also get them at Harbor Freight. $7, and you will save yourself a ton of money refilling your own 1 pound propane bottles. So that pretty much covers that. The next thing, we talked about the battery box having to be vented. Basically what we ended up doing was, you already saw in one of our other videos, I want to say part 10 or part 9, was the battery was in the back corner. I showed you the 12 volt fuses, the wiring, whatever. What I did was, because it's underneath the back corner of the bed, it's all sealed airtight per se. So I'm not gonna have Robbery do it, but underneath I have another one of these vents. These were soffit vents from the depot. Basically there's one on the bottom, air comes in, the hydrogen gas, which is what these batteries release, vents out of the top. So fresh air in, and hydrogen is, I think, like 5 times heavier than air, so it vents.
And I believe lighter, so we'll go with that.
No, hydrogen is 5 times heavier than air. That's why air goes in the bottom, comes out the top. And my cameraman's going to argue with me on my video.
I love doing this.
This is great. Like, no, I know what I said. But anyway, but yes, no, I know hydrogen is heavier than air. Thus, the Hindenburg, it rises. So anyway, I put one of these down on the bottom.
Let us move on, shall we?
Okay. Anyway, you need to vent it. Fresh air in the bottom. Well, you started this.
I'm sorry.
We're having fun. We love doing these videos. Oh,
yeah, we really
we
do.
We love bickering back and
forth.
Yeah,
we get a kick out of it.
So, anyway, but yes, the battery box is vented. Like I said, if you do it, the batteries that we're using, we had before we started this build, but I would suggest sealed batteries. If you do a sealed battery, you don't need to do this. Ours vent. We need to vent ours. So there's that. So when I go around the side, we're gonna show you kind of what we have here, which no matter where you go, if you're gonna do campgrounds, I would always suggest everything on, per se, what I call the passenger side. I'm not sure if it's right or left, but it's always the driver's side. We got the outside shower. We got our city water connection. The power port, which you already saw. The new thing I added was my cable connection for when we do have cable. Once again, an eBay score for $7. It goes just like a half inch hole, connects to the side, and the cable goes up to the front where the TV is going to be. We talked about the plumbing that we did. So obviously you saw the fresh water intake, and basically what I have right now, which I have to modify, is basically it's one drain, it comes down, it's gray water, which is basically washing your hands, whatever, not a big deal, but in theory you need to plumb it. What I'm gonna do is, it's an inch and a half pipe, which is your typical kitchen pipe diameter. Hook it up with just a water hose, because I'm not doing sewer, and hook it up to the drain. The other thing we also did was, I told you about the propane. I was back and forth on the whole deal. But what I ended up actually doing was, this is your typical 20 pound propane tank. Because of the trailer being a V-nose, there is no space to mount this outside on a regular basis. I don't want to put it in the back because, heaven forbid, for some reason I get rear-ended, this is not a good spot either. So basically what I ended up doing was, I found that a typical milk crate, my propane tank fits in. When we're traveling, I can set it in the camper, I can secure it, and it's not a problem. When I want to use it, I hook it up, and I can store the hose inside the, basically, this is an electrical compartment, but it works, my hose fits, and that is what we have for our propane. It's a little bit of work, but unfortunately for our situation, this was the best solution we had. Like I said, There's no room on the V-nose, not to mention it also adds a lot of extra weight on the front. The back was not a good spot, and you do not want to mount this inside and actually use it. So this is what we do. It's not a big deal. I get here, I carry it out here, set it here, hook up the hose. It took us maybe 15, 20 minutes to hook up everything. The fresh water, the propane, and the electric. Next thing I'm gonna show you is our electric setup. And this is a little bit more technical. Like I said, you know, obviously, you know, I do a lot of electrical, and, you know, so this is your typical post at most campgrounds. So I'm gonna show you is everything's got a breaker. All right, you've got a 50 amp breaker. You got a 20 amp for, you know, the 110 outlets, a 30 amp breaker for obviously your 30 amp outlet. So being that Robbie and I both have RVs that can use 30 amp, what we did was this cord that's actually plugged into the 30 amp is Robbie's. What we did was we got a, I call a dog bone. I think a lot of people, if you do electrical, do a dog bone, is we can split the electric into two sections. So basically it went from 50 amp to 30 amp right here. So I have 50 amp coming down this leg and it goes to my 30 amp connector, okay? It's not a problem because everything I did in the camper is on a 20 amp breaker. You really can't overuse the power. And we got it off of eBay. It was used, I think I want to say maybe like $40.
Something like that, like yeah.
Buying brand new to probably about $100, but that is how each of us have our full 30 amp service. Like I said, as long as you do everything properly with heavy enough cord, you won't have any issue. That's why there's breakers here, there's breakers in the camper. The wire size is the right size. Just if you are, I'm going to read this, we talked about it once before, if you do not know electric, do not do anything electric, because one of my bosses, he told me loose wires cause fires. Electric is nothing to play around with. If you are not comfortable with it, do not mess around with it, okay? One of the things also is if, you know, we're getting close to the finish of our build, we're gonna do a couple more videos because we don't have a lot to do, but if there is something that you want me to, and Robbie, to go more in depth, I can go more in depth with a lot of things. I've been told I talk too much, I'm too technical, but if there is something that you want us to focus on, I can do a video specifically on whatever it is that you might want to see. Like I said, I've done this for over 20 years, this kind of stuff, electrical, plumbing, whatever. I know what the code requirements are, whatever. We can do a specific video for you. If you go look back, I did not a lot of views on it, but the hurricane straps, I did a specific video because one of our viewers wanted to know, what are you talking about? I will be more than happy to do a video on whatever. It might not be for everybody, but if it'll help you, I'd be more than happy to do a video in more in depth to show you kind of, you know, it, you know. Like I said, we try to give you a general overview without being boring, and basically Robbie was saying it's like, it's too late? Yeah, well, but, you know, if you want to see it, we'll show you. All right, let's move on. Safety chains. Like I said, this is a Diamond cargo trailer. The only thing I did not like about it was the safety chain connections. We did a camping trip to Sebastian Inlet like 5 or 6 months ago. All it was insulated with the wood on the walls. And on the way there, we lost the safety chain. And the factory safety chains came basically as a tow hook, which somehow came undone. It had a safety. I don't know what the heck happened. But over the years with the trailers I've had, I like this design better. Basically, these are a connecting link. They screw together, okay? Now, and this is basically it. They just screw together. There is no way that they are coming unhooked. If you hit a dip, a bump, whatever, they go in. You screw them together, and you're connected. There is no way that this is going to jump up, fall off, whatever. Now, if you do this, and I've done this for a long time, make sure they are rated for the capacity. All right, this trailer is rated from the factory for 2,900 pounds. Each of these, and of course you're gonna have two of them, each of these is rated for 2,000 pounds. That is 4,000 pounds between the two of these. The trailer's only rated for three. These are more than adequate for what you need, and they, like I said, they do not unscrew, they don't fall off, and I would recommend them. Robbie and I have done this on pretty much every trailer because there is no way that they are going to come off. And those work. Let me just double check my notes because we were covering a lot of stuff here today. The only other thing that we're going to do is Robbie is going to give me the camera because one of the things, like I said, we're almost done. I love the fact that Robbie and I have almost 20,000 views with the camper build and 170 subscribers. Evidently, you guys like what we're doing.
Thank you very much, YouTube.
And thank you very much. I'll be honest, this was the first time we did it. I'm really shocked that you guys love our videos that much, which thank you very much. But the next thing that we're going to do, like I said, we're almost done. It's going to be little detailed stuff, but the next thing that we want to do is, we didn't do it early on, but Robbie's build. So I'm going to let Robbie take over and talk about, after this is done, the next series and what we're going to show you along the same lines. Just another option that I know is very popular as well.
All right, Robbie.
All right, YouTube. Thank you, Dave. Basically, we're going to do another series, and it's going to be a van, obviously, duh. But we did the same basic idea of the camper build we did in a high-top conversion. Stripped it out and made a camper out of it. Most of it's all done, but the dynamics pretty much are the same. The electrical's the same, the 12 volt, all that is the same as there.
We basically did it twice.
Yeah, we did it twice, but we weren't smart enough to do a YouTube video on this. So we're gonna go back and show you. So if you're kinda like, man, that's cool, but I'd like to do a van, this thing is cool. This is a bit of a tease, but we're definitely gonna come back. I think you're gonna get a lot of good ideas. And you're going to find that there are differences, obviously, between trying to do a van and the camper. So hopefully that you'll come back once we start this video series, and we'll keep on taking up, keep taking your answers and your questions. And you know, I just want to thank you all very much for watching. I want to thank Dave for doing the camera. I thank him for being brief. And
anyway, it was brief. I did good.
Anyway, you know, subscribe, like, comment, please. We love it, guys. Thank you very, very much. Happy Thanksgiving. God bless you and God bless America.
And I'm just going to throw out there, our email address again is D as in David, LEHMANN1976@yahoo.com. Thank you very much and God bless, and we'll see you hopefully next week. We'll be back on track.